People are still talking about last week's vice presidential debate in Danville, Kentucky. WISN 12 News' Kent Wainscott was there to watch it all play out. In an upfront exclusive, Kent talks with Kyle Downey, a Cedarburg native who helped prepare Congressman Paul Ryan for the debate.
There were obviously issues that you knew that you had to prepare for, that you knew would come up in this debate, taxes, the future of Medicare, Afghanistan, Iran. But what about surprises? Did anything catch you off guard as you were watching this?
Well, I was actually surprised at how much time was spent on foreign policy. Joe Biden is considered by many, a foreign policy expert because it's been one of his issue areas that he's put a lot of time and devotion into over his many years in public service. And Paul Ryan, I thought, absolutely held his own. And when it comes to Libya and what's happening in Iran and the way that this administration has completely misstated and misrepresented what happened in Libya, I thought that Paul Ryan really took it to Joe Biden on those issues.
So how does this now set the stage for the next presidential debate coming up in just a few days?
Well, I mean, look, Governor Romney had a great debate last week. I think Paul Ryan won tonight, and these polls continue to close. So, you know, the president, he's going to be making up for lost ground. It's going to be something to tune into.
Kyle Downey, thank you very much for taking a few minutes to talk with us. The question, of course, now is, will it matter? Will this vice presidential debate do anything to shift the momentum one way or another in this race? We'll find that out in the days ahead. Mike, back to you.
Our thanks to Kent Wainscott for that report from Kentucky. They called Thursday night's debate in Danville the thrill in the ville, and it probably mattered more than some vice presidential debates of the past. So did the candidates stick with the facts to make their case, or was truth a casualty? We're joined now by the managing editor of factcheck.org, Rob Farley, who's here now on the satellite from their offices in Philadelphia. Rob, thanks for being with us. Give us sort of a general sense of Thursday night's debate. Did they stick pretty much to the facts?
Not so much. We found, there's a lot of exaggerations, to make political points, to score points. And this kind of thing we hear over and over on the stump, they're repeating the same lines at this point over and over again.
Can you give us an example, maybe, where each of them strayed a bit from the truth or embellished in an exaggerated way?
Sure. For example, Paul Ryan said, look, we're both from small towns, Joe Biden and I. I'm from Janesville, Wisconsin. He's from Scranton, Pennsylvania. And he said, unemployment in Scranton went from 8.3% to 10%, which is true. And he said, this is the story all around the country like this. Now, that's not true. In fact, as we know, unemployment is at 7.8%. That's exactly the rate that it was when Obama took office. Mm-hmm. And interestingly, in Janesville, Wisconsin, you've got an unemployment rate that dropped more than 4 percentage points over the same time period.
How about Joe Biden? Did he say things last night that simply were not the truth?
You know, he exaggerated some on the funding for this amount of embassy security, saying that the Republicans cut it by $300 million. And that included some construction costs and things like that. It had nothing to do with security. So it was more of a stretch than anything. It was about $264 million. So not the worst thing in the world, but, a stretch for sure.
Did he have another problem on that one, Rob, where he said that they didn't know that there were any requests for extra security? Was that a problem for him on that answer?
We looked into that, and certainly it's true that there was some complaints made by the consulate about that. Whether that got all the way up to the highest ranks is still unclear. That's being looked into. But, certainly the folks in the State Department at lower levels would have been made aware of that.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk about this quest for truth and what your organization does. You know, when you watch a debate like that, you'll see each candidate cite different reports, different studies that prove their point. For example, if we're talking about tax policy, why their tax policy would be more effective. How do you get to the truth in something like that where you have different organizations reaching different conclusions?
And you really got to read these reports. So often you're hearing the Democrats characterize the Romney tax plan, and they're citing the Tax Policy Center. It's a nonpartisan group. But the way that they're representing it has been very misleading. They're talking about some assumptions that they're making about Romney's plan. They're saying, look, the math just doesn't add up. Therefore, we think the way he's going to compromise is he's going to raise taxes on the middle class. Romney said, for starters, I'm not going to do that. Conversely, You know, here you've got this group that says, look, you know, your math doesn't quite add up on this plan. Something's got to give. And, you know, they come back and they say, well, we've got 6 studies that back up that say that, you know, this can work. Now, when we look at that, we can, you know, we say, look, there's a lot of studies here that are, have some partisan interest here. We've got some people that are affiliated with the campaign that you're referring to. Or in other cases, there's some studies that are making assumptions that Romney said he wasn't going to include in his plan. So those aren't really backing for his plan. You got to really dig into these studies to find out, you know, why they're, you know, perhaps biased.
Rob Farley is the managing editor of factcheck.org. We appreciate your time. Thanks very much for being with us today.
Oh, thank you for having me.
And I'll be back with some final thoughts and more of our interviews with newsmakers. You can go to the upfront page of WISN.com.